Hello and welcome to Pobal's online tutorial series for Iris. The purpose of this tutorial is to support users in identifying records where corrections, updates or follow-ups are required. To assist you in checking your data, Pobal has designed several system views which can be found in Iris under the Performance Monitoring section. To run these views, click on Performance Monitoring, select the relevant beneficiary type, either individuals, local community groups, structures and networks, or non-caseload supports. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will be checking individuals. So firstly, select individuals from the list. Then, open up the System View drop-down list. There are three different types of data quality control views available to use. Data check. These views return records where you may need to update the information, such as records that were answered with no response, or to check which registered individuals are not yet on the caseload or have no contract for at least 3 months. Data follow-up updates. These are prompts for you to identify where follow-up is required and where information is required to be input or updated. You should update the records so that they are no longer included in the view. Over time, more records will be added to this list and they may meet various criteria for follow-up. Data issues errors. These views should not return any records at all if the related data has been input correctly and is valid. Records on these lists need to be updated or, if necessary, deactivated so that they are no longer included in the view. For this tutorial, we will select No Response Homelessness from the Data Check section. Once you have selected the view, Iris will show you a list of all individuals who answered No Response to the Homeless or Affected by Housing Exclusion question. For a full explanation of each data check and quality control system view available, please consult our Data Check and Quality Control System views on the Iris User Guide, located here as shown. Once Iris has generated a list, all the usual options for sorting or filtering the records still apply. Records can be filtered using the A to Z options at the bottom, or by clicking the filter switch as shown. This brings up a drop-down list, which gives various options from the headings of each column. You can also run searches using the search box. These lists can then be exported to Excel using this button here.